Hello everyone, welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Angular, that is Angular version 19 on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily start working on your Angular projects by just creating one Hello World program. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in the middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'll definitely going to help you. So now to install Angular, you'll need basically two things. First is Visual Studio Code and Node.js. So for that, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and then you need to search over here, Visual Studio Code download, and hit enter. So that's going to show you this code.visualstudio.com. So you need to click on this link and immediately it's going to redirect to the official site of Visual Studio Code. So this link I'm going to provide right in the description. So once when you are here, depending upon what operating system you're using, you need to download Visual Studio Code for Windows. I'll just simply click on that and our Visual Studio Code going to start downloading. Next software that we'll need is Node.js. So just simply open a new tab and just simply type Node.js download and hit enter. So that's going to show you this Node.js.org as a first source result. So you need to click on this Node.js download and it's going to redirect to the official site of Node.js. Again, this link I'm going to provide right in your description. So once when you are here, you will see there is this package manager tab, then pre-built installer tab. Alright, so you need to switch to this pre-built installer tab and then you will see this button of download Node.js version 2022. Alright, so you need to download this LTS version of Node.js, that is version 22. Just simply click on that and immediately you will see that it is rightly started downloading. So both our Node.js and Visual Studio Code is rightly downloaded. Let's minimize our browser and go to our download directory. So here you can see both these two software. Let's start installing it one by one. We'll start with Node.js. Just simply double click on it. So welcome to Node.js setup wizard. Just simply click on next. Accept the license agreement. Always read this, accept it, click on next. So this is where our Node.js is going to be installed. Everything is fine. Click on next. So all these different module it's going to install. Just simply click on next. We don't want to install Chocolaty. We just simply want only Node.js. So we'll skip this and click on next. So ready to be installed. Click on install. So that's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And there you go. You can see that our Node.js is rightly started installing. So by the time our Node.js get installed, I'll request you please to consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos. So if you subscribe this channel, that's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And now you can see that our Node.js is rightly installed. You can just simply click on finish. And now it's time to install our another software called Visual Studio Code. Just simply double click on it. This is a license agreement. You can always accept this. Click on next. So this is where our Microsoft Visual Studio Code is going to be installed. Everything is fine. Click on next. Again, click on next. We'll check all these different options and click on next. So ready to be installed. Click on install. And immediately we'll see preparing to install and it is rightly started installing our Visual Studio Code. So let's minimize our download directory and let's wait for a couple of minutes over here. And there you go. So you can see that our Visual Studio Code is rightly installed. So launch Visual Studio option is also checked. Click on finish. So that's going to launch our Visual Studio Code. So it is rightly launched. So everything is fine. Let's close this. So now that you know that both our Visual Studio Code and Node.js all are rightly installed, it's time to install our Angular. So for that, you need to first simply go to search and just simply type cmd to open your command prompt. And within command prompt, you need to just simply type npm install -g @angular/cli. And then just simply hit enter. So what we are going to do is we are going to install Angular globally. So that's why you are using this flag called -g. And you need to have active internet connection for this because it's going to fetch a lot of files from internet and going to set up your Angular locally on your system. and you can see that our Angular is rightly installed. So now to check whether Angular is properly installed on your system or not, just simply type ng space v and hit enter. So that's going to show you this latest version of Angular CLI, that is Angular CLI version 19.0.1, you know, on your console. So if you see this similar type of prompt, then all that basically mean is your Angular is rightly installed on your system and now you're good to start working on your Angular projects. So let's see how we can create an Angular project. So for that, let's close this. Let's on our desktop, let's create a new folder as Angular projects, and within this folder of Angular project, let's invoke our command prompt. So just simply type cmd on that this bar and hit enter, and it's going to open our command prompt right at this location. And now to create an Angular project right at this folder, all you need to do is you need to just simply type ng new, then you need to provide your project name. So let's give the project name as hello-world and hit enter. So what it's going to do is immediately it's going to, you know, start creating your project. Before that, it will ask you whether you'd like to share anonymous data to them. You can always do that, just type y and hit enter. So thank you for sharing some pseudo users' data. So that's going to help to improve their product. And here it is asking to provide some information like what type of style sheet you want, whether you want a CSS or SAS or LESS, all that. I'll keep it simple, so I'll just keep it CSS. If you want to change it to SAS, you need to, you know, press that downward key on your keyboard and you can navigate to all these different options. I'll keep it simple, so I'll make it CSS. Hit enter. Next, it is asking whether you need to enable the server-side rendering and the static site generation, all that. So I'll be creating a very simple project, so I'll not go into that complexity. So I'll just, you know, keep it simple. So I'll type in and hit enter. So that's going to, you know, set as no, and it would immediately start creating our Angular project. You can see it has actually started doing that, right? And it is currently installing our package of npm. So it's going to take time, you know, a couple of minutes. So let's wait for some time. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that our Angular project is actually created. So package installation is successful. Let's go inside our project called Hello World. So just simply type cd, then hello-world and hit enter. So now we are inside our project of Hello World. So now we'll invoke our Visual Studio Code. So for that, just simply type code, then dot and hit enter. So that's going to invoke our Visual Studio Code. So it's going to ask you whether you'd like to trust the authors and all. Just simply click on yes, and there you go. So you can see that our Hello World project is rightly opened on Visual Studio Code. So you can close this welcome note and let's expand our src folder, and here you will see a file called index.html. You can invoke app folder, and there we'll have all these different components. We have app component over here. This is our app.component.ts. This is our app.config file. This is our route file, and this is our HTML file. And remember, we have created just a simple CSS project. So this is our that CSS file. So here all the codes are written over here. So let's see how to run this project. So to run this project, first thing that you need to do is you need to hover over this triple dot for Explorer. Just click on this triple dot and then you need to enable this npm scripts. So when you click on that, you will see npm scripts, you know, over here. So to expand this npm scripts, and then you need to, you know, click on this start button over here. So just click on that, and immediately what it's going to do is it's going to start executing this command called npm run start. So it's going to build our project, and then it's going to give us one URL, one local host URL can be run on our browser. So here just type n, maybe hit enter. So our project actually started building, and once when it gets successfully built it, as I told you, it's going to give you one URL. So to, you know, click on this follow URL, and that's going to invoke on our browser the default browser, and within that default browser it's going to invoke our project of Hello World. So congratulations, your app is running. So a Hello World project is up and running on our local host URL. So as I was talking about, so this is our HTML file. So what you are seeing over here is actually getting rendered over there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove whatever there on this content. So I'm going to select all this, and I'm going to remove everything till this div. So I'll delete, and I'll just simply create one h1 tag, and I'm going to print Hello World. Right, so just simply go to file and save this file. Immediately on our browser you're going to see that everything going to be wiped out, and it's going to only show Hello World on our browser. Right, and in this way you can start working on your Angular project. So just start working by creating new component, new module and all that. Alright, so in this way install latest version of Angular on Windows operating system. Don't forget to subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos, and also if you're interested you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And I'm posting lot of videos on WordPress, so if you're interested you can also watch all those videos as well. I'm going to put all the links on our description, so do also follow my other videos. Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you the best way to create an e-commerce website in less than 50 minutes. So after watching this video, you'll be able to create your very own online store just like this for free. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this.